Hare Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. कृष्ण कृष्णाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी निधि नामने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारण निर्विशेष शून्यवादी ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
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 ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय.
We're having Russian translation here, yeah? And yes. Chinese translation. So in the last week we had some wonderful festivals. We had, of course, first of all, Ram Nomi took place.
上周我们过了很多非常美好的节日, 比如说 Ram Novami.
It's about 1 week ago now, I think Ram Nomi happened.
我想大概其 Ram Novami 过完了已经有一周的时间了。
Ram Nomi is a very big festival in Delhi and in Mumbai. It's not quite so popular in Bengal.
Ram Nomi 在德里和孟买非常的受人欢迎，在孟加拉并不是特别的普遍。
Anyway, we do always observe these festivals. It's important for us, and it's on the Vaishnava calendar, and we observe fasting on that day.
无论如何，这个是非常重要的节日。 这个在我们的Vaishnava的日历上，所以那一天我们努力的遵守戒食。
In the Lagu Bhagavatamrita, it is stated that besides Lord Krishna, two other avatars are very important. One is Lord Rama, and the other is Lord Narsingha.
在Lagu Bhagavatamrita之中据记载，除了主Krishna之外，另外有两个化身非常的重要，其中之一是Rama，另外的一位是Narsingha。
So the worship of Lord Rama, of course, is very popular. It's all over India, North and South India.
当然了，对主Rama的崇拜是非常的普遍流行的，既在南印度、北印度也都有。
Lord Ramachandra appeared over in Ayodhya, which is over not far away from Vrindavan, not far away from Naimisharanya.
主Ramachandra显现在Ayodhya那个地方，离Vrindavan、离Naimisharanya并不远。
So Lord Ramachandra's pastimes are described, the authorized version of Lord Ramachandra's pastimes is the Valmiki Ramayana.
关于主Ramachandra的权威性的经典描述参见于Valmiki的Ramayana。
Unfortunately, people are more familiar with a book called the Ramcharitmanas, which is by Tulsidas, which is in Hindi.
但是不幸的是，人们更熟悉的书叫《Ramcharitmanasa》，是由Tulsidas写的。But
Prabhupada said the actual authorized version of Lord Rama's pastimes is Valmiki
Ramayana。但是薛罗帕帕德说，关于主Ramachandra的权威的逍遥时光的经典是Valmiki的Ramayana。And
it's written 24,000 verses. The Bhagavatam was 18,000 verses. Ramayana is 24,000 verses.
他一共写了24,000个诗节，Srimad Bhagavatam有18,000个诗节，但是Ramayana有24,000诗节。So
each 1,000 slokas begins with the one of the different letters from the Brahma Gayatri mantra. There are 24 syllables in the Brahma Gayatri. So every 1,000 verses, it will begin with one of the different syllables from the Brahma Gayatri.
在这24,000个诗节之中，每一千个诗节都会以Brahma Gayatri的一个音节开始。Brahma Gayatri一共有24个音节，所以在每一千个诗节的一开始会以这24个音节之中的一个开始。It's
an indication that the Ramayana is like the Brahma Gayatri, is a meditation on the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
这就表明，主Ramachandra这个逍遥时光Ramayana 是相当于Gayatri，是一种对至尊人格手持逍遥时光的冥想。
So Lord Ramachandra appears in the Treta Yuga. He is a Lila avatar. He's not Yuga avatar, he's a Lila avatar.
朱拉姆山的显现在 Treat Yoga， 他是一位 Lila Avatar， 他不是 Yoga Avatar， 是 Lila Avatar。
And he comes, but then his purpose in coming is to show the pastimes of a perfect king。
他到来展示逍遥时光，为的是表明一个理想的国王应该怎么做。
When he appeared at that time, the whole planet was, there were many Rakshasas, particularly, of course, there was the demonic king Ravana, who was very prominent and very much feared by all the demigods.
当他显现的时候，这个地球上有很多的 Rakshasa， 其中最有影响力的是 Ravana， 有很多的半神人，他们都甚至是害怕他。
Ravana was so powerful.It said that when Indra's elephant came attacking, the elephant broke his trunk on the chest of Ravan.
据说 Ravana 非常的强大有力，当 Indra 的坐骑大象来攻击他的时候，大象的象牙居然就折断在了 Ravana 的胸膛上。
So Ravana considered himself so powerful, nobody could oppose him.
Ravana 认为自己非常的强大，没有人能够把他拉下来。
He was so proud that he did not bother to get any benediction to be protected from any human being.
他非常的骄傲，所以他就根本没有想自己需要一个保护，就是说保护一种祝福的保护，免于人类的攻击。
He thought human beings, they're not powerful enough, they could never give any trouble to me. I don't need any benediction to protect myself from them.
他认为人类是非常没有力量的，所以非常微不足道的，我并不需要任何的祝福保护我免于人类的攻击。
So understanding this pride in Ravan, the Lord appeared in the human form.
了解到 Ravan 的这种骄傲，主便以人类的形体显现。
And he took birth in the family of the great king Maharaj Dasarath.
他在伟大的国王 Maharaj Dasarath 的家中投生。
Maharaj Dasarath had three principal wives. There was Gosalya, Sumitra, and Kaikeyi.
Dasarath, 他有三位主要的妻子 Kosalya, Sumitra, 还有 Kaikeyi.
So, Maharaj Dasarath for a long time was not able to get a child. Finally, he was blessed with four sons.
Maharaj Dasarath 很长时间没有任何的子嗣，但终于他得到了四个儿子。
Lord Rama was his son, appeared in the womb of Gosalya.
Rama 是 Kosalya 子宫之中生出来的儿子。
Bharat was born the son of Kaikeyi.
Bharat 是 Kaikeyi 生的。
And Lakshman and Shatrughna were the sons of Sumitra.
而 Lakshman 和 Sumitra 是
Lakshman
和 Bharat 是 Sumitra 生的。
So the four brothers, they are all consideredVishnu Tattva.
这四个兄弟都被认为是 Vishnu Tattva.
Means they're as good as the personality of Godhead.
这意味着他们跟人格守神是一样的。
Just like Lord Krishna, Lord Krishna appeared with his different family members who were also Vishnu Tattva, like Pradyumna and Aniruddha. They're also Vishnu Tattva.
就像主 Krishna 显现的时候，他的家人也属于 Vishnu Tattva， 比如说 Pradyumna、Aniruddha， 他们都属于 Vishnu Tattva。
So Lord Ramachandra with his brothers, they grew up the sons of Maharaj Dasarath, and they were well trained in all the military arts.
主 Ramachandra 和他的弟弟们在 Maharaj Dasarath 的宫廷之中长大，他们在军事科学方面受到了良好的训练。
At a certain point, Vishwamitra came to the home of Maharaj Dasarath.
曾经有一次 ，Vishwamitra 来到了 Maharaj Dasarath 的家。
Now, when a saintly person comes to your home, we should think it's a blessing.
当一位圣人访问你家的时候，你应该认为这是一个祝福。
But at the same time, you should understand sometimes they come to your home with a purpose.
但你应该明白，有时候他们来你家是有目的的。
They want to get something.
他们想得到一些东西。
So you have to be careful.
所以要小心呢。
You're going to receive a saintly person at your home. You don't know what they're going to ask you for.
你在家里接待一位圣人，你不知道他们会跟你要什么。
Anyway, Maharaj Dasarath felt very honored to receive Vishwamitra in his home, and he fell at his feet and he praised him and glorified him.
无论如何，马哈吉达萨拉斯他觉得自己能够接待威士密特是非常幸运的事情，于是他跌拜在圣人的莲花足下，去顶拜他，荣耀他。
And he told him, "Whatever you ordered me to do, I will certainly do. How can I serve you? Please tell me."
他说，无论你让我做什么，我肯定都会去做的。请告诉我，我如何才能够取悦你
？So Maharaj Vishwamitra was pleased, and he praised Maharaj Dasarath. That's very good. You're a very pious king. You're very noble. You're very charitable.
Vishwamitra 就赞美了 Maharaj Dasarath， 说你是一个非常高贵的国王，你非常的乐善好施，你特别好。
So he said, "I've come. Now I need something from you. I need some charity from you."
他说，我来你这儿呢，我其实需要一些东西，我需要你给我一些布施。
So Maharaj Dasarath said, "Yes, anything. My treasury, it's all yours. Whatever you like, you can take."
Maharaj Dasarath 说，任何的东西，我整个的这个财富的这个宝库，你想要什么你就拿什么吧。
My kingdom
都是你的。
My kingdom is at your disposal.
我的整个的国度都是在你的号令之下。
But Vishwamitra said, "No, I just want to get your son."
但 Vishwamitra 说不，我只想要你的儿子。
Of course, that was the last thing which Maharaj Dasarath ever wanted to hear.
当然了，这个肯定是 Maharaj Dasarath 最不愿意听到的。
And he was very, very disturbed. He thought, you want my son? Why would you want Ram? Why would you want Lord Ram? Why would you want my eldest son? What could he do for you? He's just a boy.
他非常的受到打扰，他说。为什么你要我的儿子呢？你为什么要我的长子 Ram？ 他只不过还是一个孩子。
Vishwamitra said, "Well, there are some Rakshasas, and I want your son to go and kill them."
Vishwamitra 说，有一些 Rakshasa 们，我想让你的儿子们跟我一起，我想让你的儿子跟我一起去杀了他们。
And when Maharaj Dasarath heard this, he thought, "Oh no!" My son is just a young boy. It will be very dangerous. His life will be at risk. So I will go. Let me go in place of my son.
Maharaj Dasarath 马上就说，我的这个儿子他只不过是一个小孩，他如果去的话太危险了，我代替他去，你让我去吧。
So Maharaj, Vishwamitra got a little angry. He said, "Look, you promised me you would give me whatever I wanted."
Vishwamitra 有点生这个国王的气，看，你答应我，无论我要什么，你都会给的。
Now you're going back on your promise.
现在你要收回你的诺言吗
？You give your word to a saintly person. Now you're going to break your word. It will be very inauspicious for you.
你对一位圣人许下了诺言，现在你想打破你的诺言，对于你来讲，这么做会非常的不吉祥。
Oh, Maharaj Dasarath was trembling. What to do? Oh, please, just.Anything but Ram. Let me go with my army. We will take care of all the Rakshasas.
Maharaj Dasarath 浑身颤抖，他说，我可以给你任何东西，除了 Ram 之外，让我和我的所有的军队跟你一起去吧。
But Vishwamitra,
我们去杀 Rakshasa 们。
Vishwamitra would not, his mind would not be changed. He said, "No, the only person who can go and deal with these Rakshasas is Ram."
但是为什么 Mitra 的心思没有任何的改变，他说唯一能够对付得了这些 Rakshasa 的人就是 Ram。
And Vishwamitra said, "You don't have to worry. I'm going to give him all the mantras, all the astras, so he can easily kill these Rakshasas."
Vishwamitra 说，你不用担心，我会教授他所有的 mantra, 所有的 astra, 所有的武器，这样他就可以杀死这些 Rakshasa。
Vishwamitra said, "I could have killed the Rakshasas myself, but I'm a Brahmana.I'm not supposed to kill."
Vishwamitra 说，其实我自己就可以杀了这些 Rakshasa 们，但是我是一个 Brahmana， 我不应该杀戮。
It's the duty of the Kshatriyas to kill these people.
下雪的职责才是杀这种人。
So Maharaj Dasarath said, "Then I will go. I will do it."
然后 Maharaj Dasarath 大喊，那我去，我做吧。
But Vishwamitra said,"No, I don't want you to do it. I want your son to come and do it."
但 Vishwamitra 说，不，我不想让你做，我想让你的儿子去做。
So Maharaj Dasarath had to concede. He had to give Vishwamitra his desire.
Maharajdhatarath 不得不让步，他不得不满足 Vishwamitra 的愿望。
So Ram went along with Lakshman because wherever Ram would go, Lakshman would always accompany him.
于是 Ram 跟 Lakshman 一起去，因为无论 Ram 去什么样的地方 ，Lakshman 都会陪着他。
Bharat was always with Shatrughna.
Bharat 总是跟 Shatrughna 待在一起。
And Ram was always with Lakshman was always with Lord Ram.
而 Lakshman 总是跟主 Ram 在一起。
So Lakshman along with Lord Ramachandra went off with Vishwamitra, and they went into the forest, into the jungle where there were many Rakshasas, and the first Rakshasa they had to kill was a woman.
于是 Lakshman 就陪着 Ram 跟着 Vishwamitra 去森林里，在森林里他们要杀那些 Rakshasa 们，而他要杀的第一个 Rakshasa 其实是一个女人。
There was this very demonic woman she was very sinful. She killed, eaten many innocent people.
有一个非常邪恶的 Rakshasa.他特别的非常的罪恶，杀死很多的无辜的人。
And she lived in this forest. Where she lived, the whole forest had become dead. All the trees had died. Nothing was living in her presence.
他住在森林里，只要他住的那个地方，所有的生物全都死了，连树都不是活的。
So Lord Ramachandra, with the help of the astras given to him by Vishwamitra.He was able to kill this Rakshasi woman.
于是 Ram 就在 Vishwamitra 给他的这些astra 武器还有 mantra 教导之下，他就把这个恶毒的女人杀了。
And they went on to kill several other Rakshasas.
接着他们去继续的杀另外几个 Rakshasa.
And then Vishwamitra wanted to take Lord Ram along with Lakshman. He wanted to take them to the palace of Maharaj Janak.
接着 Vishwamitra 想带着 Ram 还有 Lakshman 去 Maharaj Janaka 的宫殿。
We were in safari. We went to Sitamari, the birthplace of Mother Sita.
我们在 safari 的时候去了Sitamari, 也就是 Sita Devi 的出生地。
And not far away from that place, about 20 kilometers only, is Janakapur.
离这个地方不远，大概是20公里，有一个地方叫做 Janakapur。
We have ISKCON temple there in Janakapur.
在 Janakapur 那个地方，我们有伊斯康的庙。
And the devotees, when we came there to Sitamari, the devotees came from Janakapur to be with us, and we had a big Sankirtan festival.
而当我们去 Sitamari 的那里的时候呢，奉献者来自 Janakapur 就从那儿到了 Sitamari， 跟我们一起做了一个 Sankirtan。
So.Maharaj Janaka, he had in his home, he had the bow of Lord Shiva.
Maharaj Janaka 的家里拥有主 Shiva 的弓。
And that bow could only be lifted by 200 men.
那张弓只有200个人才能够抬起来。
Before they could even move the bow, it took 200 men to come and move it.
哪怕是把这张弓移动一下，都需要200个人才能动得了它。
But Maharaj Janaka observed.That his own daughter Sita, she was able to lift the bow on her own.
但是马哈拉吉加纳可注意到他自己的女儿 Sita 一个人就可以举起这张弓。
So Maharaj Janak considered that if my daughter is going to marry, she has to marry a man who is her equal.
于是马哈拉吉加纳可就在想，如果我的女儿结婚的话，她必须要嫁给一个跟她对等的人。
If the qualities of the husband and wife, if they're not very matching, then it'll be very difficult for them to get along.
丈夫和妻子如果他们之间不是特别般配的话，他们就没有办法好好过下去。
Just like when the husband and wife are both serious in Krishna consciousness, then they can advance very nicely in Krishna consciousness.
当丈夫和妻子他们都非常般配的时候，他们可以都处在 Krishna 知觉之中，这样双方就可以一起在 Krishna 知觉之中进步。
So same way, Maharaj Janak considered that my daughter, that somehow she has divine powers, that she could lift this bow of Lord Shiva, which took 200 men.
同样道理，马哈迦那卡就在想了，如果谁要是想去娶我的女儿的话，他必须也能够举起这个200人才能够举起的弓。
So if she's going to marry, she has to marry somebody who's able to pick up that bow also.
如果要因为我的女儿能举起这个弓，她一个人，然后如果她要是嫁给一个人，那个人也必须能够一个人举起这张弓。
So it was announced, anybody who wanted to win the hand of Sita in marriage, the daughter of Maharaj Janak.They had to come there and they had to show their skill. They had to pick up the bow of Lord Shiva and string the bow.
于是宣布，如果谁想娶马哈拉吉加纳卡的女儿 Sita， 他就必须要能够把这个主 Shiva 的弓举起来，还要给他上上弦。
But even though so many great men came, none of them were able to begin to pick up the bow.
尽管很多伟大的人来了，但是他们没有一个人能够甚至是开始举起这张弓。
And it was arranged. Vishwamitra, but he brought Lord Ramachandra there, and Lord Ramachandra, he came there, and he, with ease, he picked up the bow and he strung the bow, and then he bent the bow and broke it.
后来 Vishwamitra 就带着 Durama 到了那里，然后 Durama 他不仅把这个弓举起来，而且给他上上弦，并且把它给弄弯了，把它给折断了。
So seeing the power of Lord Ramachandra, Maharaj Janak immediately brought his daughter Sita and offered his daughter Sita as the wife of Lord Ramachandra.
看到主 Ramachandra 的这种孔武有力的这种举止，他立刻就把自己的女儿 Sita 带来，把自己的女儿献给了主 Ramachandra.
Mother Sita is the goddess of fortune herself. She is the eternal consort of the personality of Godhead.
Sita 妈妈实际上她就是幸运女神，她是永恒的至尊人格守神的伴侣。
So she is often called Janaki, the daughter of Maharaj Janak.
她经常被称为 Janaki, Maharaj Janaka 的女儿。
So we saw in Sita Mari, we saw how very nice, everybody there is very devoted to Lord Ramachandra and Mother Sita and.It said 1 month after Ram Nomi, after the appearance of Lord Ram, is the appearance of Mother Sita.
在 Sita Mari, 我们看到每一个人都对 主 Rama 还有 Sita 充满了奉爱之情。据说在 主 Rama Ram Novami 的显现日之后一个月是 Sita 妈妈的显现日。
So they have a very big festival there every year.
每一年他们在那里会举办非常盛大的节日。
So Lord Ramachandra broke the bow of Lord Shiva.that brought him a little trouble. On the way, when he was returning back to Ayodhya with his newly married wife, he was confronted by an angry Lord Parasuram.
因为主 Ramachandra 他折断了主 Shiva 的弓，所以当他带着他自己新婚的妻子 Sita 返回 Ayodhya 的时候，在路上他遇到了一点点小麻烦，他遇到了非常愤怒的 Parasuram.
Now Parasurama is also Vishnu Tattva. He had killed the Kshatriya race 21 times.
Parasurama, 他也是 Vishnu Tattva. 他杀死了 Kshatriya 的这个种族一共21次。
And when he saw this Kshatriya king come and break the bow of Lord Shiva, he was very angry.
当他看到这位 Kshatriya 的国王居然来折断了主 Shiva 的弓，他非常的愤怒。
He did not immediately recognize who is Lord Ramachandra.
他没有立刻的认出主 Ramachandra 到底是谁。
And he confronted Lord Ramachandra in his anger. He brought another bow and he confronted Lord Ramachandra and told him, "Show me who you are. Show if you are really the supreme lord. Then show me. Take this bow of Lord Narayan."
于是他挑战了主 Ramachandra.他又拿来了一张弓，然后让主 Ramachandra 把它给举起来。他说：“给我展示一下，你到底是不是至尊主？如果你是的话，你就给我拿起这张弓，因为那个是主 Narayana 的弓。”
And Lord Rama, of course, he just took the bow in his hand and smiled.
主 Rama 当然了，他轻易的拿起了弓，放在手里微笑。
And Parasuram understood and offered his respects to Lord Ramachandra.
Parasuram 明白了，于是他就向主 Ramachandra 致敬。
So Lord Ramachandra took his wife back to Ayodhya and continued to enjoy family life there. His brothers were also married at the time of his marriage to Sita. His three brothers were also married, and marriage arrangements were made for each of them. So the four brothers each had their wives.
主 Ramchandra 带着他的妻子 Sita 回到了 Ayodhya， 于是他们就开始过着幸福的居士生活。而在他结婚的时候，他的三个弟弟也被安排都娶了妻子，所以每一个人都有自己的妻子。
So it happened in course of time that Lord Ramachandra, that there was some intrigue in the palace.
随着时间的流逝，在宫殿里发生了一场阴谋。
Bharat and Shatrughna had gone to visit their in-laws. Bharat was the son of Kaikeyi, and Kaikeyi, her father was in another kingdom. So Bharat and Shatrughna had gone there to see the father of Kaikeyi.
Bharat 和 Shatrughna 他们出去了，他们去访问 Kaikeyi 的父亲，而就是哦对。巴拉特的母亲是 KK， 然后 KK 的父亲他们去访问他。
KK is the youngest wife of Maharaj Dasarath.
KK 是 Maharaj Dasarath 最小的妻子，最年轻的妻子。
He had three principal wives.
他有三个主要的妻子。
He had many other wives.
他还有很多其他的妻子。
360 other wives.
还有另外360个其他的妻子。
Krishna had 16,100 wives.
Krishna 有一万六千一百零八个妻子。
Eight principal wives.
八个主要的妻子。
So Maharaj Dasarath, his youngest wife was Kaikeyi. Because she was youngest, so he had the greatest affection for the youngest wife.
那么 Kaikeyi 是 Maharaj Dasarath 最年轻的妻子，所以他对这个妻子格外钟情。
So.It happened that Kaikeyi had a boon from Maharaj Dasarath. Previously, she had helped her husband when he was in a battle. She had helped to save him. And at that time, Maharaj Dasarath felt so indebted to her that he offered her boons.
Kaikeyi 从 Maharaj Dasarath 那里得到许诺，会得到一个祝福，是因为当初在 Maharaj Dasarath 有困难的时候 ，Kaikeyi 帮助了他，所以当时呢 ，Maharaj Dasarath 觉得非常亏欠 Kaikeyi 的，就答应了他，以后他想要任何的祝福都会给他。
So Kaikeyi said, "I don't want anything now. Maybe in the future, if I need something, I will ask you."
Kaikeyi 当时说，我现在不需要什么，将来我需要的时候，我会跟你要的。
So this fact was known by one evil-minded maidservant called Mantara.
那么这件事情被一个心思邪恶的仆人所了解，他的名字叫 Mantara.
So this maidservant polluted the mind of Kaikeyi.
这个女仆污染了 Kaikeyi 的心思。
You know, in family life, there's always difficulties. There's always intrigue and politics going on.
你们知道吗？在家居生活之中，总是有困难，总是会有一些阴谋，甚至是政治。
Even though you may be the supreme personality of Godhead, and you have a goddess of fortune for the wife, still there can be problems.
即使就是说，丈夫是至尊人格守神，妻子是幸运女神，但仍然会有问题。
So it happened that.Maharaj Dasarath, he decided he wanted to arrange the coronation of Lord Ram, the eldest son, that he should become the king.
怎么样呢？是 Maharaj Dasarath, 他决定要为自己的儿子 Ram 加冕，让他成为国王。
But when Mantara heard this, she went to Kaikeyi and she told Kaikeyi, "This will be very bad for you."
当 Mantara 听到这个消息的时候，他立刻去找 Kaikeyi， 他说如果这样的话对你是非常不利的。
Your son will have no position. Ram will be the king. Your son will have no position.
你的儿子将没有任何的地位可言，如果 Ram 当了国王，你的儿子就没地位了。
And you will also be neglected. Nobody will care for you.
而且你也会受到忽略，再也没有人在乎你。
So you have to do something. You have to protect yourself.
你必须得做点什么自保。
You have two boons from your husband. You should use your two boons.
你的丈夫答应给你两个祝福，你应该现在使用那两个祝福。
One boon, tell him you want Bharat, your son, to become the king, and not Ram.
一个祝福，你告诉他你想让你的儿子 Bharat 成为国王，而不是 Ram.
And the second boon, that let Ram go and live in the forest for 14 years.
第二个祝福就是让 Ram 去森林里待14年。
So, Kaikei was influenced by the evil thinking of this maidservant woman.
Kaikei 当时就受到了这个心思邪恶的女仆的影响。
And she took advantage of her a position as being the favorite wife of Maharaj Dasara to control her husband.
她利用了自己作为 Maharaj Dasara 最受宠的妻子的地位，她控制了她的丈夫。
Maharaj Dasara was vowed to truthfulness.
Maharaj Dasara 他发誓要真诚。
There's a famous saying in the Ramayana. They say,Ragu Kuli Rakchaliai Pranjayarun Vachanajai.
This is the Ramayana, this is a very famous sentence.
That better I would give up my life than tell a lie.
我宁可死也比说谎强。
This was the mood of these great Kshatriya kings like Maharaj Dasarath.
这就是像 Maharaj Dasarath 这样伟大的国王的情感。
That they would rather die than have to tell a lie.
他们宁可死也不会撒谎。
Nowadays, people would rather die than tell the truth.
现在的人他宁可死也不说真话。
Difficult to get people to be truthful.
很难找到那些真诚的人。
This is Kali Yuga.
这是 Kali Yuga.
So Kaikei, she told her husband that you have to give me these two boons.
凯凯告诉她的丈夫，你应该给我实践这两个诺言。
Maharaj Dasarath, of course, he did not want to agree.
Maharaj Dasarath, 当然他不愿意同意。
But Kaikei forced him that you cannot lie. You've promised me. You have to keep your word.
但是凯凯强迫了他，你不能够就是说不答应我。你已经对我许下了诺言，必须要实践。
So at this time, Bharat and Shatrughna, they'd gone off to the in-law's home. They were away in another kingdom.
在这个时候 ，Bharat 和 Shatrughna 他们是去了岳父的这个家里，他们在另外一个国家。
Actually, Bharat would never agree to become the king over Ram. He was devoted to Lord Ram.
其实 Bharat 永远不会答应要。在 Ram 之上成为国王，他对 Ram 充满了奉爱之情。
The four brothers had perfect love and cooperation with each other.
四个兄弟他们彼此之间是有完美的这种互相关爱的关系，非常好的合作关系。
The three younger brothers all respect the greatest love and respect for Lord Ramachandra.
三个弟弟对主 Ramachandra 有最大的敬意和爱戴。
And they all had love for the three mothers also, this Kaikeyi and Sumitra and Goshalya. They were all loved equally by the four brothers.
而且所有的四个兄弟平等的爱所有的这几位母亲，那就是 Kaikeyi, Sumitra, 还有 Goshalya.
Nobody was thinking, she's not my mother.
没有人想着，她不是我的母亲，她不是我的母亲。
All the brothers showed equal love and respect for the three mothers.
所有的兄弟对于三位母亲都有同等的爱戴。
And there was perfect harmony, but somehow this evil-minded maidservant woman polluted the mind of Kaikeyi.
本来大家都处在完美的和谐之中，但不知怎的，这个邪恶的女仆污染了 Kaikeyi 的心思。
And nothing could change the mind of Kaikeyi.
没有任何东西可以改变 Kaikeyi 的心意。
She was demanding that Ram has to go to the forest and my son Bharat should become the king.
她要求 Ram 必须去森林，我的儿子 Bharat 一定要成为国王。
So Lord Rama, one moment his father was telling him, "Tomorrow I want you to become the king."
对于 Ram 来讲，片刻的时间，他的父亲一度说，明天我想让你成为国王。
And the next moment, he was told, you have to go and live in the forest for 14 years, and Bharat will become the king.
下一刻他被告知你要去森林里住14年 Bharat 会成为国王。
So how does Lord Rama respond to these things? He takes it all in his stride. He's not disturbed.
Bharat 主 Ramchandra 如何接受这一切呢？他就是很高高兴兴地接受了所有的这一切，没有任何的受打扰。
He simply tells his father, "My dear father, whatever you desire, I am your servant. Let me simply fulfill your order."
他仅仅告诉他的父亲，亲爱的父亲，无论你想要什么，我都会去做，我就是想满足你的训令。
So Lord Ramchandra, he is Maryada avatar. He is showing the perfect behavior.
主 Ramchandra 他是一位 Maryada avatar， 他展示的是完美行为举止的榜样。
Whatever is asked to do, he will do it without question.
无论要求他做什么，他都会毫不迟疑的去做。
He's very obedient to the order of his father.
他非常的去对他的父亲的训令很恭顺。
And he's very concerned that his the honor of his father should be preserved.
而且他很关心。应该维护他的父亲的荣誉。
He thought if my father is known to have broken his promise, it will be very bad.
他想，如果大家知道我的父亲打破自己的诺言，那是很糟糕的事情。
So Lord Ramachandra is so exemplary in all of his dealings.
主 Ramachandra 在他所有的交往上都是榜样。
So immediately he began to prepare to go to the forest, and he told his wife Sita.That he will go to the forest. So then Sita said, "Then if you're going to the forest, I will also come with you."
他立刻开始做准备去森林。他告诉自己的妻子，我要去森林。但是当 Sita 听到这番话的时候，他说，我要跟你一起去森林。
So Lord Rama was not eager. He thought, no, you shouldn't come to the forest. It will be very difficult for you to sleep on the hard ground and to eat wild fruits and berries.
主 Ram 说，不，你不能跟我一起去。如果你躺在地上，主 Ram 强的说，不，你不能够躺在森林的这个地上睡觉，然后只吃那些水果根茎之类的。
But Sita said.No, for me it's not a problem. I can also do these things. If you can do it, I can also do it.
但是西达说，不，对我来讲不是问题。如果你能做到，我也能。
And you're my husband. It's my duty to follow you.
你是我的丈夫，我的职责就是追随你。
It is said, actually, even though you may have a son, you should never give up the husband.
据说即使你有了儿子，都永远不应该放弃丈夫。
The wife should follow the husband.
妻子应该追随丈夫。
So Sita was in this way. She convinced Lord Ramachandra that she could also go with him off to the forest.
这样 ，Sita 就说服了 Ram， 他可以能够跟他一起去森林。
So when Lakshman heard that Sita was going to the forest with Lord Ram, then Lakshman also came and told Lord Ram, "I also want to go with you."
当 Lakshman 听说 Ram 要去森林的时候，他也来了。他说，我也想跟你一起去。
Well, Lord Rama said, "Well, I know you like to." I said, "But if you go, everyone in Ayodhya will also want to go, and the whole of Ayodhya will become the forest, and the forest will become like Ayodhya."
然后主 Rama 说，不行，你不能去。如果你去的话，整个的 Ayodhya 的人都会跟着我们去森林，然后呢，森林就会成为 Ayodhya， Ayodhya 就会成为森林。
We don't want the whole of Ayodhya to become a jungle.
我们不想让整个的 Ayodhya 成为一片丛林。
You should stay here. You have to take care of our mothers.
你应该待在这儿，你应该照顾我们的母亲们。
But Lakshman was insistent. He said, "No, actually, the mothers will be all right. They'll be looked after. Bharat is coming back with Shatrughna, and the two of them will both be able to take care of the mothers without any problem."
然后 Bharat 就说，其实母亲们他们会被照顾得很好的，不用担心他们。而且 Bharat 和 Shatrughna 他们会回来，他们回来可以好好的照顾他们，不会有任何的问题。
But I should go with you. I've always been with you, and I want to stay with you.
但是我应该跟你一起走，因为我一直跟你在一起，所以我应该跟你一起。
So in this way, somehow Lakshman was able to convince Lord Ramachandra.That he could also go with him.
这样无论如何 ，Lakshman 就说服了 Ramchandra， 他可以跟他一起去。
So Lord Ramchandra told them, "All right, you're going to go to a forest for 14 years with me. You have to prepare. You have to go home Give away all of your valuable jewelry and possessions. Give everything away in charity.
然后 Ram Chandra 就告诉他们说，如果你们跟我一起去的话，你们应该放弃所有你们的这些富裕的这些装扮，应该把所有的这些首饰都作为布施派发给别人。
This is the system. You want to go off to the forest, you want to renounce, you have to give up all your attachments.
就是这种体系，如果你想去森林，如果你想弃绝的话，你应该放弃你所有的那些衣服。
You don't just give it to your family, but you give it to people, needy people. You give it to the worthy people, who are people who are able to make proper use of wealth.
你不应该就是只是给你的家里人，你应该给那些需要的人，那些能够恰当的运用你的财富的人。
Some people go to live in Vrindavan and they give all their wealth. They leave it with their family. They never give any charity to the Brahmanas. They never give to this for spiritual purposes.
有的人他们住在 Vrindavan， 但只是跟自己的家里人在一起，从来不会给其他的 Brahmana 布施啊，或者做其他的贡献。
But Lord Ramachandra instructed Lakshman and Sita, you go back and you give away everything in charity. Give it to the great sages and the brahmanas. Give it to those who are in need.
主 Ramachandra 告诉 Lakshman 还有 Sita 说，你们回去把自己所有的东西都派掉，要给那些圣人们，给 brahmana 们，给那些需要的人们。
And Ramayana describes there was this one brahmana who was very poor, who had a wife and had several children, a big family.And no wealth.
Ramayana 之中提到有一个 Brahmana， 他非常的贫穷，有一个妻子，有好几个孩子。
So he came to Lord Ramachandra to get some charity.
他来找 Ramachandra 要一些布施。
So Lord Ramachandra gave him one stick. He said, "Throw as far as you can throw the stick. We will give you that number of cows that can fill that space."
主 Ramachandra 送给他一根棍子，说你就把这根棍子扔出去，这根棍子能够覆盖多远的距离，我们就给你多少头牛。
So the Brahmana took the stick and he threw it right across the Sarayu. The Sarayu River is there in Ayodhya. So he threw it right over the Sarayu, covered a huge area.
这个 Brahmana 拿到棍子之后，立刻把它扔出去，然后他就整个扔过了 Sarayu 这条河，他就覆盖了很大的一片区域。
So Lord Ramachandra was very happy and he gave that Brahmana many, many cows to fill that area.
主 Ramachandra 非常的高兴，他给这个 Brahmana 布施了很多很多头牛，整个区域都占满了。
Lord Ramachandra did not feel any dejection or sorrow about going off to the forest.
主 Ramachandra 对森林没有任何的沮丧啊，或者是悲伤的感情。
He took it all in his stride. He showed perfect control over the mind and senses.
他欣然接受，他向我们做出了完美控制心意和感官的榜样。没电了 ，Maybe we should change battery. Hare Krishna.
Okay.
Yes.
We hope that it will be okay. So Lord Ramachandra is the perfect example in all of his dealings, how he dealt with everyone in such a wonderful way.
主 Ramachandra 在他做的所有的事情方方面面都表现出他做的非常的周到，非常的完美。
There's one principle which is there in the teaching of Lord Ramachandra.
在主 Ramachandra 的教导之中有一个原则。
Just like in the teaching of Lord Krishna, the ultimate principle is to surrender to Krishna.
就像是在 Krishna 的教导之中有一个主要的原则，那就是臣服于 Krishna.
Sarva dharmam parigyashnam mamik. When Krishna said, give up all your material religion and surrender to me, I will protect you.
Sarva dharmam parityajam mamekam saranam vraja. Krishna 说放弃所有其他的一切宗教，只臣服于我。
So similarly, Lord Ramachandra, he is also given the instruction that anyone who ever even once comes to him and takes shelter of him and to get protection, Lord Ramachandra promises that I will give them protection, I will give them shelter.
同样道理 ，Ramachandra 他就答应，哪怕一个人只有一次来到面前说托庇于他的话，他都说我要给他保护，我要给他庇护。
even though they come only one time, they just come once. But because they've come, they've approached Lord Ramachandra, then I can never give them up. I will free them from all fear.
哪怕他们只来一次，就哪怕他们只是来主找主 Ramachandra 一次的话，主 Ramachandra 都答应说，我会保护他们，他们不会有任何的恐惧。
And that is the overriding principle in all of the dealings of Lord Ramachandra.
这个在主 Ramachandra 的所有的交往之中，算是一个非常主导的原则。
So Lord Ramachandra, but along with Sita and Lakshman, they prepare themselves to go off to the forest, and they accept clothing made of wood.
主 Ramachandra 于是就跟 Sita 还有 Lakshman 做好准备要去森林，他们接受了用木头做的衣服。
Yes, they make clothes. Just, you know, we make cloth out of cotton or out of synthetic.
对啊，因为我们可以接受像棉布啊，或者是化纤的东西做成的衣服。
But if you're going to become an aesthetic and go to live in the forest, then they have this cloth which is made from the bark of trees.
但如果你要是成为苦行者，住在森林里的话，就必须要穿用树皮做的衣服。
And so they gave the dress to Sita, and Sita, she'd been a princess, she'd been brought up in the palace.She didn't know how to wear it.
他们把这个衣服给 Sita. Sita 是在宫殿里长大的一位公主，她不知道怎么穿。
They had to show her how to put on this dress, how to wear this cloth.
他们要给她展示怎么把这个衣服穿在身上。
So if all the people in Ayodhya, their hearts were breaking to see the three of these three great saintly personalities dressed in the bark of trees.And going off to the forest.
Ayodhya, 所有的人，当他们看到这三位非常圣洁的人穿上树皮做的衣服，准备启程去森林的时候，他们的心都碎了。
All the people of Ayodhya, they wanted to go with Lord Ramachandra.
Ayodhya, 所有的人都想跟 Ramachandra 一起去。
They wanted to follow. They loved him so much.
他们特别的爱他。
It is said when Lord Ramachandra left this world, at that time, all the people of Ayodhya.They also left with him.
据说当主 Ramachandra 离开这个世界的时候 Ayodhya 所有的人都跟他一起离开了。
They all went back to Godhead together.
他们都一起回归守神了。
Just like people in Vrindavan were so devoted to Lord Krishna, so the people of Ayodhya were so devoted to Lord Ramachandra.
就像是 Vrindavan 的人们非常的献身于主 Krishna 一样，而 Ayodhya 的人们非常献身于主 Ramachandra。
They were all his eternal associates.
他们全都是他永恒的同游。
It is described there was one Brahmana who every day before he would take his food, he must come and see Lord Ramachandra and offer his obeisances.
据描述说，有一位 Brahmana， 每一天他在吃东西之前必须要来见 Ramachandra， 顶拜他。
And without seeing Lord Ramachandra, he would not take food.
如果没有看到 Ramachandra 的话，他是不会吃东西的。
So sometimes it happened that Lord Ramachandra would go out and tour around the kingdom, and he would not be back for several days.
但有的时候 Ramachandra 会在全国进行巡游视察，所以好几天他都不会回来。
So at that time.That Brahmana would come and he would not find Lord Ram. He would remain fasting the whole day and he would fast for several days.
在那个时候，如果这位 Brahmana 来，但是找不到主 Ramachandra， 他看不到 Ramachandra， 整整一天都会戒食，然后接下来的几天之内他都会戒食。
When Lord Ramachandra heard about this, Lord Ramachandra felt very sorry and he gave this Brahmana, he presented him his own deity.
当 Ramachandra 听到这件事情的时候，他很难过，于是他送了这个 Brahmana 一尊自己的神像。
And he told this Brahmana, he said, every day, he said, you can simply offer obeisances to myself in the form of this deity.
于是他告诉这个 Brahmana, 你可以每一天向以这个神像表现出来的这个我呢去顶拜。
So that deity is still worshipped today. It's there in Udupi.
这尊神像至今还在乌杜皮受到崇拜。
For some time, it was taken to Jagannath Puri.
曾经一度，它被就是送往 Jagannath Puri.
But it shows the worship of the deity has been going on for many thousands of years.
但是这表明，对于这尊神像的崇拜是有成千上万年、数百万年。
When we were in Sitamari, they took us to one place. They said they found the deity of Lord Ramachandra there. They found the deity there 400 years ago.
当我们在 Sitamari 的时候，他们说在那儿发现了一尊神像，那尊神像有400年的历史。
Man told me 1599 is like 420 something years ago.
那个人告诉我是1599年发现的，所以应该是说有420多年了。
They found this deity and they established the worship of Lord Ramachandra. They considered this must be the actual place where Lord Ramachandra has been worshipped.
他们找到这尊神像了，然后他们就说一定是主 Ramachandra 受到崇拜的地方就在这里。
So like that, there are many deities of Lord Ramachandra which are very, very ancient, hundreds, thousands, and thousands of years old.
所以就像这样，有很多主 Ramachandra 的神像，几十年、几百年、上千年，甚至上万年。
So Lord Ramachandra, along with Lakshman and Sita, they went off to the forest to live in the forest for 14 years.
主 Ramachandra 连同 Lakshman 还有 Sita 一起去了森林，他们在森林里住了14年。
And for several years, they were very happy. They were enjoying the beauty of the forest.
有好几年的时间，他们非常的高兴，他们非常享受森林的美丽。
Of course, when they went to the forest, they prepared themselves. They did not go unarmed, but they brought with them their own weapons to defend themselves.
当然了，他们去森林里的时候也并不是说赤手空拳，他们带了自己的武器来保护自己。
Particularly they had these bows with their arrows.
尤其他们带了弓和箭。
And so, if there was any danger, they were prepared.
如果有任何危险的话，他们是有所准备的。
But for several years, there were no problems. They were living peacefully. They were enjoying the beauty of nature.
有好几年的时间没有任何的问题，他们非常的享受自然的美丽。
But then it happened that Surpanaka happened to come by.
结果 Surpanaka 来了。
And Surpanaka is the sister of Ravan.
Surpanaka 是 Ravan 的妹妹。
And she's a Rakshasi, she's a flesh-eating woman, and she had mystic powers.
她是一个 Rakshasi, 是一个吃肉的女人，她也有玄秘的力量。
And so she made herself, and she made her, by her power, she made herself into the form of a beautiful young woman.
通过她的力量，她把自己变成了一个美丽的年轻女子。
And she approached Lord Ramachandra.
她去接近主 Ramachandra.
And she requested Lord Ramachandra that, you know, you should satisfy my material desire.
他请求 Ramachandra, 你知道吗？你应该满足我的物质愿望。
No, Lord Ramachandra explained to her, "Well, I have my wife with me. You know, I have my wife. Why don't you go to my brother? There's my brother over there. You know, you can approach him."
主 Ramachandra 说，你知道，你看我是带着我的妻子一起来的，我跟我的妻子在一起。你为什么不去找我的弟弟呢？我弟弟就在那边。
And so, at first, Surpanaka then went to Lakshman and.Tried to converse with Lakshman, but Lakshman was not taking interest in her either.
于是 Surpanaka 去找 Lakshman, 他想跟 Lakshman darshan, 就是 darshan, 但是呢 Lakshman 呢对他根本不感兴趣。
No, of course you could say, well, this is against the Kshatriya culture, because Kshatriyas are meant to satisfy any woman who approaches them.
再次，其实这种行为被认为是违反了 Kshatriya 的这种文化，是因为一个 Kshatriya 如果有任何女人去找你的话，你应该满足她的愿望。
It's the duty of the Kshatriya that he can accept more than one wife.
Kshatriya 的职责便是他可以接受不止一个妻子。
And if a woman approaches the Kshatriya, then the man is the Kshatriya is expected to satisfy her and.Give her the child she wants.
如果一个女人去找一个 Kshatriya 的话，这个 Kshatriya 应该是满足这个女人的，应该给她一个她想要的孩子。
But Lord Ramachandra understood that this is some evil-minded woman. I don't want to have anything to do with her.
但是 Ramachandra 知道这是一个很邪恶的女人，我不想跟她有任何的关系。
But she saw Sita and she became very jealous of Sita and she began to attack Sita.
但是当他看到 Sita 的时候，他非常的嫉妒，于是他开始攻击 Sita。
So when she attacked Sita, then Lord Ramachandra took action against her and he cut off her nose and cut off her ears.
当他攻击 Sita 的时候，主那个他们就开始 Lakshmana, I missed that.
Lord Ramachandra,
主 Ramachandra 就砍掉了 Supanaka 的鼻子和耳朵。
And when seeing herself all disfigured and cut to pieces, she went screaming and ran off to her brother Ravan.
她现在被毁了容，于是 Supanaka 就尖叫哭喊着去回去找她的哥哥 Ravan.
And so Ravan didn't take it very seriously until Supanaka told Ravan about the beauty of Sita.
Ravan 本来没把这个当一回事儿，直到Supanaka 告诉 Ravan 关于 Sita 的美丽。
And Ravana is very attracted to beautiful women.
Ravan 呢非常受到美丽女子的吸引。
So this is the whole structure of the demonic race, that they're very much concerned with money and women.
这就是整个的恶魔他们的这种重视的事情，他们最关心的就是金钱和女人。
And Ravan, he had actually a curse against him.
其实对于 Ravan 来讲，他自己本来受过一次诅咒。
Previously, he had raped the wife of another demigod.
先前他曾经强奸过一位半神人的妻子。
So the demigods were not powerful enough to take action against Ravan.
这个半神人没有足够的力量去对 Ravan 采取措施。
But they did put a curse on him.
但是他对他下了一个诅咒。
And the curse was that if he ever forced another woman to have sex with him.Against her will, then he would certainly die.
那么他这个诅咒说，如果你要是再次去违背一个女子的意愿，去强迫她的话，你肯定就会死。
So Ravana was aware of this curse.
Ravana 非常的清楚这个诅咒。
But he was still attracted to Sita.
但仍然他受到 Sita 的吸引。
He had heard that she was the most beautiful of all women on the planet.
他听说她是整个星球上最美丽的女人。
And so he was.He thought he must capture her. He must have her for his own entourage.
他想他一定要抓住她，一定要让她成为自己的随从。
So in this way, Ravana arranged to kidnap Sita.
这样 Ravana 开始安排绑架 Sita.
In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it describes when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling in South India, he met one Brahmana who was lamenting.How Mother Sita had been kidnapped by Ravan.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 之中描述说，当初 Chaitanya 在南印度旅行的时候，他遇到了一位 Brahmana。这位 Brahmana 在悲伤 Sita 母亲被 Ravana 所绑架。
So it happened that after Lord Chaitanya met this Brahmana, later on Lord Chaitanya found one scripture which describes that Mother Sita was never touched by Ravan, but Ravan took a Maya Sita.
在这件事情发生之后，朱柴坦尼找到了一部经典。那部经典里说，其实 Sita 母亲从来没有受到过 Ravana 的触碰，而 Ravana 他所绑架的那个是一个影子的 Sita.
The actual real Sita, she was replaced by a Maya Sita, and Ravana took the Maya Sita.
真正的 Sita 被 Maya Sita 所替换，所以 Ravan 他带走的是 Maya Sita。
Mother Sita is a pure goddess of fortune, and the demon Ravana could never put a hand on her.
Sita 妈妈她是纯粹的，非常纯净纯粹的幸运女神，而恶魔 Ravana 永远不可能让自己的手染指她。
So when Lord Chaitanya found the scripture, he brought it back to the Brahmana and he told the Brahmana, and the Brahmana was very, very glad to hear this news.
朱柴坦尼找到了这部经典之后，他就把它带回来给这位 Brahmana. Brahmana 非常的高兴听到这个消息。
But ordinary people were bewildered by these things. They think Mother Sita was taken by Ravan.
但是普通的人会被这些事情所迷惑，他们认为 Sita 母亲被 Ravana 带走了。
And it happened after Lord Rama's exile was over and came back. He proved the chastity of Mother Sita by having her walk through the fire.
而在这个森林的这流放结束之后呢？ 主拉玛他证明了西塔母亲的贞洁，通过让他走过烈火。
She walked through the fire. The Maya Sita burned in the fire, and the actual mother Sita came out of the fire.
她走过了烈火，玛雅西塔在火中被烧尽，而真正的西塔从火中出现。
But while Lord Ramachandra came back to Ayodhya and became the king, he was ruling the kingdom. But there was always he was always concerned. What do people think about him?
后来，主 Ramachandra 回到 Ayodhya 成为国王，统治国度。他非常的关心人们对他有什么样的印象。
And he would send spies around the kingdom every day to listen to what people are saying about the kingdom.
每一天，他都会去派间谍到全国各个地方去聆听、去打探，看看人们对他有什么意见。
He wanted to know what is their criticism.
他想知道大家的批评是什么。
So usually there was no criticism.But it happened one day that one messenger heard some very inauspicious things.
通常没有任何的批评，但是有一天有一个间谍就听到了一些非常不吉祥的消息。
One messenger told Lord Ram that he heard a barber argue with his wife.
有一个信使告诉主 Ram 说，他听到一个理发师跟他的妻子在吵架。
His wife had been unchaste. She'd gone off with another man.
他的妻子是不贞洁的，跟另外一个男人跑了。
And after some time, she came back to her husband.
过了一段时间之后，她回到她的丈夫身边。
So the husband said to his wife, "Lord Ram may take back his wife after she's been with another man, but I'm not taking you back."
于是丈夫对他的妻子说，主 Ram 可以在他的妻子跟另外一个男人走了之后再接受他回来，但是我不会接受你回来了。
So the messenger told these words to Lord Ramachandra.
于是这个信使就告诉了主 Ramachandra 这些话。
So when Lord Ramachandra heard this, he thought, there is some doubt about my position as a husband and the position of my wife Sita.
然后呢，当 Ramachandra 听到这番话之后，他想，人们对于我的地位还有我的妻子 Sita 的地位有所怀疑。
So he thought,Let Sita go and stay in the ashram of Valmiki.
他说，那就让 Sita 去住在 Valmiki 的 ashram 吧。
And he requested Lakshman, you take Sita and leave her in the ashram of Valmiki.
他要求 Lakshman, 你带 Sita 把她留在 Valmiki 的 ashram 里。
So at this time, Mother Sita had conceived. She was carrying twins within her womb.
这个时候 ，Sita 母亲已经怀孕了，她的子宫之中有一对双胞胎。
Later on, she gave birth to the two twin boys, Love and Kush.
之后，她生下了一对双胞胎的男孩 ，Love 和 Kush.
And after she delivered the two boys and put them in the care of Valmiki, then Mother Sita returned to the earth.
当她生下这两个孩子之后，让她就把这个孩子转给了 Valmiki 来照顾，她返回到大地之中。
She was born from the earth. She did not take birth in the usual way. She did not take birth from the womb. She appeared from the earth.
她不是通过通常的子宫那样生出来的，她生下来的时候就是通过大地生出来的。
And when she returned into the earth.
当她返回的时候，也是返回到大地之中。
So when Lord Ramachandra got the news how his wife had finished, how departed from this world, he was very heartbroken.
主 Ramachandra 当他听到他的妻子是如何离开这个世界的时候，他非常难过，心都碎了。
But he had made a vow, only one wife.
但是他发了一个誓，只有一个妻子。
Usually we were telling Maharaj Dasarath had many wives.
我们知道 Maharaj Dasarath 他有很多的妻子。
Lord Krishna had many wives.
主 Krishna 有很多的妻子。
But Lord Ramachandra his vow Eka Patni Vrata only one wife.
但是主 Ramachandra 他发了一个誓，叫做 Eka Patni， 也就是只接受一位妻子。
And although he's a Kshatriya king, he could have had many wives. He did not take any more wives.
尽管他是一个神奇的国王，他可以接受很多的妻子，但他没有接受一个妻子之外的任何妻子。
And when he was king, he was ruling the world for thousands of years.
当他是国王的时候，他统治世界成千上万年。
He had to perform many rituals. Without a wife, it was very difficult. So he had a deity made of Mother Sita, and the deity would sit by his side as his wife.
作为国王，他要举行很多的仪式，但如果没有自己妻子的陪伴，他很难去完成这些仪式。于是他打造了一尊西塔的神像，他就让神像当做自己的妻子，坐在自己的身边。
So in this way, Lord Rama was able to fulfill all his duties as a king.
这样 ，Rama 可以完成自己作为一个国王的所有的职责。
So this was in the Treta Yuga. So he lived for many thousands of years, ruled the world for, I think, 26,000 years.
这个就是发生在 Treta Yuga. 我想他统治了很多年，应该是26,000年。
Then returned to the spiritual world.
然后返回到灵性世界。
After he had killed all the demons, particularly this demon, Ravan,Lord Ramachandra had fulfilled his mission in coming to the world.
之后他杀死了很多的恶魔，尤其是杀死了叫做 Ravan 的这个恶魔，这样主 Ramachandra 便完成了他来到这个世界上的使命。
And we see that also Mother Sita, her appearance was also necessary in order for Lord Ramachandra to be able to go after Ravan and kill him.
而且我们可以看到 Sita 她的显现也非常的重要，能够促成Ravan 去能够促成主 Ramachandra 去找 Ravan 并且杀死他。
So Lord Ramachandra lives eternally in the spiritual world along with his consort Mother Sita.
主 Ramachandra 永恒的跟他的伴侣西塔母亲住在灵性世界里。
In the spiritual world, there's also Ayodhya.
在灵性世界里也有 Ayodhya.
And the devotees of Lord Ramachandra are residing there.
主 Ramachandra 的奉献者们住在那里。
But Hanuman, he didn't go there.
但是 Hanuman 并没有去那里。
He stays in a place called Kimpurusha Loka.
他住在一个名叫 Kimpurusha Loka 的地方。
Which is one of the regions around Mount Meru in the planet of Bhumandala.
这个是在 Bhumandala 上面，在梅如山上的一个地方。
But Hanuman is told that whenever there is recitation of the glories of Lord Ramachandra, Hanuman will be there.
哈努曼他有一个特殊的地方，就是每当有人荣耀主 Ramachandra 的时候，必定有哈努曼的临在。
So this is Hanuman. Although all the devotees went back to Godhead with Lord Ramachandra, Hanuman stays. He didn't go back to God. He stayed in this world.
这就是哈努曼，所有的奉献者都跟主 Ramachandra 一起回归守神了，但是哈努曼他没有，他还留在这个世界上。
But he is always chanting the glories of Lord Ram.
他一直在唱诵主 Ram 的荣耀。
And wherever there is Ram Katha, he is there. He loves to hear.
每当有 Ram Katha 的地方，他都非常喜欢去聆听。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Any questions?
有什么问题吗？
Marichi
爸爸有个问题。
Yes.
Regarding the life of Lord Ramachandra is so perfect as a king, so perfect, and the leelas are so sweet and beautiful. But there is this one leela that you mentioned, that his pregnant wife, Sita Devi, is being sent to the ashram of his Vishvamitra Muni.Because of a rumor, someone was saying what you say. And I don't know whether, I don't know, like maybe whether everybody agreed to this or not, means as a husband leaving the princess Sita pregnant like that, and after she has to leave the world alone, like a separate, you know. This part of the story.There's still something I cannot understand about that possibly, like the husband, especially Lord Ramachandra, let Sita go to the ashram and don't live together. Anyway, maybe you can kindly say some more.
Yes.
马日奇帕婆的问题是说，您讲的像书中非常的优美。但是我们看到在这个故事里呢 Sita Devi 她怀孕了，然后她又单独一个人，她离开，他们两个人是分离的，就是有一些我不能够理解的东西，然后就请您讲一讲。
And this is often something which comes up, which is difficult for people to accept.
有的时候就这一个部分非常的难以令人接受。
We have to understand first of all that Lord Ramachandra is coming to show us how to perform the duties of the perfect king.
我们必须要明白到，首先主 Ramachandra 的到来是为了向我们展示如何履行一位完美的国王的职责。
He's not coming to show us how to be a perfect husband.
他的到来不是为了向我们展示如何的去做一个完美的丈夫。
Or a perfect father.
或者是完美的父亲。
But his duty is to be the king.
他的职责是作为国王。
And as a king, he has to set the perfect example for the whole kingdom.
作为国王，他必须要为整个的国度做出榜样。
He must be above all kinds of doubt and suspicion.
他必须超越所有的一切疑问疑惑。
So because there was some shadow of a doubt from some nasty people, Lord Ramachandra took this action.
是因为有一些恶心的人，他们有一些疑惑，所以主 Ramachandra 采取了这样的行动。
He considered that there should be no doubts at all about the behavior and the dealings of the ruler.
他认为在统治者的这些日常活动之中，所有的行为举止都应该是超越一切质疑的。
So we had Mother Sita go to the ashram of Valmiki.
所以才有了西达妈妈去了 Valmiki 的 ashram.
And in this way, it was arranged that Mother Sita and Lord Ramachandra, that they were separated for some time, but that would lead to their again union together in the spiritual world.
这样呢，主 Rama 和 Sita 妈妈他们分开一段时间，但再一次在灵性世界，他们可以再次相聚在一起。
The separation which they felt would lead to their union in the spiritual world.
他们在这个时候感受到的分离，实际上可以导致他们在灵性世界的相聚。
As Mother Sita felt separation from her husband, Lord Rama also felt separation from his wife, Sita.
Sita 母亲感觉到跟她自己的丈夫之间的分离，而主 Rama 也感觉到跟自己的妻子 Sita 之间的分离。
Lord Rama had so much love and feelings for his wife Sita that he personally carved the statues, the deities of Mother Sita.
主 Ram 非常的感受到跟他妻子的这种分离的痛楚，所以他亲手雕刻了一尊 Sita 的雕像，把它当成神像。
But that separation leads to union again.
但是再一次呢，这种分离会导致团聚。
And indeed it was described in the Navadvip Mahatmya how Lord Ramachandra came here in the Treta Yuga.He came to Navadvip in the Treta Yuga along with Sita and Lakshman. They'd come to Navadvip.
在 Navadvip Mahatmya 之中描述过，在 Treta Yuga， 主 Rama 跟 Sita 还有 Lakshman 曾经来到 Navadvip 这里。
They were in the place called Modadrumadvip.
他们去了一个名叫 Modadrumadvip 的地方。
And they were appreciating the beauty of the forests there.
他们非常的欣赏那个地方森林的美丽。
And Lord Ramachandra was looking and he was smiling to himself.
主 Ramachandra 在看，然后呢，他自己在微笑。
And Mother Sita was looking at her husband and she was asking him, "What are you smiling about?"
Sita 妈妈就问他说：“你在笑什么呀？”
So Lord Ramachandra explained to her. He said, "You know, I'm thinking how in the Kali Yuga, I will come here. You will also come as my wife.And I will take sannyas."
主 Ramachandra 说，我在笑是因为我在想着在卡利 Yuga 的时候我会到这里来，然后你会跟我一起作为我的妻子来，而我会接受 sannyas。
And Mother Sita thought, she said, "Why are you smiling? You're going to take sannyas? You're going to go and leave me?"
然后西特妈妈说，那你为什么微笑啊？你要做 sannyas？ 你要把我抛下不管吗
？But Lord Ramachandra explained to her, said, "Yes, because by that separation."Then we will again be united together. There will be more pleasure in the union.
主 Ramachandra 就解释说，通过那种分离，我们将再次相聚在一起。而当我们再次相聚的时候，那种快乐会更大。
Being together all the time, after some time, you know, you don't appreciate each other.
如果一直在一起的话，过一段时间之后，你就不会太欣赏对方了。
But after some period of separation, then you start to think, when will he again come back? When will she again come back?
但是经过一段时间的分离之后，你就会去想，什么时候他才会回来啊？
So in this way, the separation leads to more pleasure in the union.
这样呢，分离其实可以导致相聚的时候有更多的快乐。
So it was arranged like this: Lord Ramachandra sent Mother Sita to the ashram of Valmiki.
于是就有了这种安排，西塔母亲被送到了 Valmiki 的 ashram.
To let Mother Sita again return to the earth, and her two sons, they can be there in the care of Valmiki, and they're brought up by Valmiki.
这样西塔母亲进入大地之中，她的两个儿子接受王 Miki 的照管之后呢，就是由王 Miki 母女所养大。
So people think, oh, this Ramachandra is so cruel, how he could do that, how he could send his wife away to the forest when she's already pregnant and he sends her away from home.
人们会抱怨说，主 Ram 他怎么能够这么残忍呢？当他的妻子怀孕的时候，怎么能够让他离开家去森林呢？
But they do not understand how Lord Ramachandra has duty as a king to perform.
但是他们无法理解主 Ramachandra 他有一个国王的职责要履行。
He has to show people the ideal example.
他必须要向人们展示完美的榜样。
Not just the example of an attached husband.
并不仅仅是一个非常依附妻子的丈夫的榜样。
But the duty that he wants to show the example of the perfect ruler.
他想展示的是一位完美的统治者的榜样。
Okay. Yes, my dear.
但是这也是一个其他年代的一个事情，但是在这个卡利年代，所有的这个丈夫妻子的这个什么已经被污染了，然后就说也没有合格的丈夫，也没有合格的妻子，但是在这个婚姻当中，发现这个丈夫或妻子他的行为不符合经典的情况下，该怎么样去消除？
Hare Krishna, thank you dear Guru Maharaj for your beautiful class. In this story it is mentioned Lord Ramchandra, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead who is the perfect husband, and Sita Devi, she is the goddess of fortune, so she is the perfect wife. But nowadays, especially in Kali Yuga, things have been changed, polluted.And not all the husband and wives, they are dealing with each other according to the principles or sastras. For example, if we find out if one party is not behaving according to the sastra, how can we react? How should we balance the relationship with him or her?
Well, in Kali Yuga, of course, as you say, it's a different situation.
在卡利尤格当然正如你所言是整个的另外一回事了。
Generally, the wife should be tolerant about the misdoings of the husband.
通常来讲妻子应该宽容丈夫的一些胡作非为。
And hope that by faithful serving, by her faithfulness and steadiness and chastity and devotion to her husband, the husband will gradually reform his character.
然后呢，希望通过妻子的这种非常忠诚的对她丈夫的服务，通过对她丈夫的奉爱，能够逐渐的感化她的丈夫。
The husband may be irreligious. It's no reason for the wife to be irreligious.
丈夫可能是非宗教的，但是妻子没有理由也变得非宗教。
I heard one couple. They say, "Oh, the man he has other women, so the wife also started going with other men."
我听说有一个夫妻，他们就这样的。妻子听说丈夫开始找别的女人，然后妻子也开始出去找别的男人。
So that is not meant to be. That's not the ideal situation.
这个不是最理想的情况。
But rather, if one party remains faithful to the religious principles. then it's hope that the other party can be reformed.
那么就是希望一方起码应该坚守这种宗教原则，这样希望另外一方得到感化，并且能够纠正。
If they cannot be reformed, then you may have to give up the relationship.
如果他们不能被感化的话，可能你不得不放弃这种关系。
It means you have to become a widow.
这意味着你要成为一个寡妇。
People are not very eager to be a widow.
人们并不愿意成为一个寡妇。
So it's better to be tolerant and wait and try to have the husband reformed.
所以呢，最好还是非常的容忍，就耐心的等着，等着有一天等你的丈夫被感化吧。
OK.
可以吗？
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, I heard from one guru and he shared the reason why Sita was successfully kidnapped by Ravana is because her offense to Lakshman. How do you comment on this? Because you know when she asked Lakshman to go to search for Rama.And Rama was refused, and he said he knew it was a trap. And Sita was, you know, keep convincing him, you know, you should go, you know, Rama was in danger. And then he said, she said, you know, Sita said very, very harsh words to Lakshman, you know, because you want to be here to enjoy me, that's why you don't want to go. So this is an offense to Vaishnava, to Lakshman, that's why.
为什么 Priya Mataji 的问题就在于，有一位 Maharaj 讲课的时候提到，为什么 Sita Devi 会被 Ravana 掳走，被他绑架，就是因为他对于 Lakshman 这位 Vaishnava 的冒犯。因为当初 Lakshman 保护他的时候， Sita Devi 对他说了很厉害的话，说你是因为你想享受我，所以你才不去帮我去救 Ram 的。所以您对此有任何评论吗？
Well, it's a reasonable explanation. Yeah, you could say it was, there was some offense there in her criticism of Lakshman.
这是非常有道理的一个解释。你可以说在她批评 Lakshman 的时候的确是有一些冒犯的。
But at the same time, you have to understand Mother Sita is not under the laws of karma.
但同时你必须要理解到 Sita 母亲她并不处在 karma 业报的法律的管辖之下。
She's the internal potency of the Lord.
她是主的内在力量。
So she's not going to get karmic reactions.
她不会得到业报的反应。
So what actually happened was just due to Lila Shakti, the power of pastime.
真正发生的事情是因为 Lila Shakti 的缘故，是为了逍遥时光的缘故。
The mother Sita had to be kidnapped by Ravan because Lord Ramachandra has to go and kill Ravan.
Sita 母亲必须要被 Ravan 所绑架，是因为这样主 Rama 才可以去杀了 Ravan.
So it was all part of the pastime potency.
所以这全都是逍遥时光力量导致的。
We cannot think mother Sita's under the laws of nature.
不能机械地认为西特母亲处在物质自然律法的管辖之下。
For Lord Ramachandra and for his consort, his internal potency, there's no question of karma.
对于主 Ramachandra, 对于他的这个伴侣，他是主的内在能量来说，他们根本就没有说 karma 的问题。
Whatever they do, it's all.Transcendental.
无论他们做什么，全都是超然的。
It's all just simply the arrangement of the Lord, so that they could go to Lanka and kill Ravan.
全都是主的安排，所以这样他可以去 Lanka 去杀了 Ravan.
All right, so we'll have some little kirtan for 10 minutes before we take prasadam.
可以吗？现在我们在 prasadam 之前再做10分钟的 kirtan.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srila Guru Maharaj ki jai.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Thank you.
Thank you.